Bollinger Bands and Candlestick Patterns are among the most popular tools among retail traders. Let's combine them both and build a short-term mean reversion strategy for the Aussie Kiwi. With its default parameters, Bollinger Bands consist of a 20-period simple moving average surrounded by a pair of upper and lower bands. These bands are placed at two standard deviations above and below the moving average. We can use the moving average to gauge trend direction, and since standard deviation measures dispersion from the mean, the bandwidth measures market volatility. Prices only penetrate beyond the bands about 10 to 15% of the time, so we can take the penetration as a sign of an upcoming reversal. But what if a new trend is developing? We want to filter out those trades, so let's make use of candlestick reversal patterns. Let's focus on four common candlestick reversal patterns. First up, we have the doji, which indicates indecision in the market. Next is the popular hammer. Sellers initially took control, but lower prices were rejected, and the candle eventually closes near its open. For the bullish engulfing, we have a bullish candle that completely covers the bearish candle before it. And finally, for the bullish piercing, we have a bullish candle that initially gaps lower, but recovers to finish above the midpoint of the first candle. All four of these patterns indicate a possible market reversal. We can make a higher probability trade by waiting for these patterns to occur together with a Bollinger Band's penetration. Let's talk about entry conditions. For longs, we are looking for a close below the lower Bollinger Band, and we want to see at least one of the four candlestick patterns described above. This doji here meets those conditions. How should we enter the market? For mean reversion trading, you should consider the use of limit orders. This means setting your entry price below the current market price. This is usually beneficial for a couple of reasons. Firstly, you get a better price. And secondly, the more overextended the market becomes, the more likely it is to revert to the mean. Think of a rubber band. The more you stretch it, the more forcefully it springs back. So for starters, we can use the high or low of the previous bar. For exits, we know there's a high probability of mean reversion occurring, so to give the trades more breathing room, I will make the stop loss twice the size of the profit target. The candlestick patterns above are pre-programmed in AlgoWizard, so we just have to choose them under candle patterns. Note the use of brackets and the OR conditions to group the candlestick pattern conditions together. As long as one of the four patterns is present, the entry is good to go. Now let's backtest on the 15-minute Aussie Kiwi for 10 years. So to conclude, even a simple mean reversion strategy using Bollinger Bands and candlesticks can indeed make you money. Just be sure not to use it on a trending market. The number of trades is a little low for 10 years, so to improve the consistency of your returns, you can trade this strategy on other sideways markets like the Euro franc as well. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you at the next video.